Kuzampola. Namaste, good morning to all respected online viewers. Long live their majesties, long live our leaders, and long live our friendship. Welcome to this online yoga workshop, Embassy of India, Thimphu, ICCS, Nehru Wangchuk Cultural Center. Yoga teacher, I'm KVSSN Murthy here. My sincere praise to the Almighty to see all the best things to their majesties in the whole Bhutan. So coming to the recitation of the sun salutation. So this, as today's workout also very simple and easiest workout. So anyone can easily follow while doing these exercises on the chair. Today is our chair yoga day. But before that, let us finish our sun salutations. So we have mantra chantings and sloka bija akshara. According to your traditional belief system, you can follow these chantings or you can follow only physical exercise part. So keep your position straight. Take a long deep inhalation and exhalation. Samasthiti or pre-position for to that actually activity. Then slowly open your two hands up and above to the head, keep a pranamasana called Kailasha Mudra, and with your total awareness and devotion, slowly bring your pranamasana down at your chest level called Anahata Pranamasana. So here we have sloka recitation. Om Hiranmayena Patrena Satyasyapi Hitam Mukham Tattvam Pushan Apavrunu Satya Dharmaya Dushtaye Om Hram Him Hrum Haim Hraum Raha Mitra Ravi Surya Bhanu Kagapushna Hiranya Gadbha Maricha Aditya Savitra Arka Bhaskaraya Namaha. And stretch your arms forward. Lift your arms completely up and once completely pull yourself and slightly or medium or deep back bend Ardha Chandrasana or Ardha Chakrasana. Then again keep your body straight. Once completely pull yourself up. And if you have lower back issues or neck strains or any other complications related to blood circulation or heart ailments, avoid forward bends in your regular activities also. So remaining people, but very slowly bend the body forward, Pada Hastasana or head to foot posture and completely press and stay now. And right leg back stretch called Aswa Sanchalanasana or horse riding posture. And after that, back leg straight on the toes and very slowly join your forward leg to back leg called Dandasana or Santulanasana. Then after that, slowly press your body down towards the floor called Ashtanga Namaskarasana or Sastanga Namaskarasana. And push your body forward and lift the body like a sea wave called Bhujangasana. Lift your chin further up and stretch it more. And another way of forward bend and another way of semi-inverted posture called Parvatasana. Take care while doing and completely press your body inside. And right leg is your again forward leg called Aswa Sanchalanasana or horse riding posture. And again our next posture will be the same Pada Hasta Asana or hand to foot posture or head to foot posture, standing forward bend. Take care while doing or avoid the practice. And then slowly, carefully lift the arms and body and head at a time up. Hasta Uttanasana, once again completely stretch your body up. And slight or medium or deep back bend Ardha Chandra or Ardha Chakrasana. Again keep your body straight. Pranamasana above to the head, Kailasha Mudra. Then very slowly bring your Kailasha Mudra down at your chest level called Anahata Pranamasana. And few seconds break. After that, lift your arms up with inhalation. And with exhalation, wide your both hands, then slowly turn them down and slowly get it back towards the thighs. Then after that, slightly wide your legs, but still keep your toes straight or inside, lock your hands back and check your breath and few seconds break for your normalized breath. Then strides, come strides. And now today we have chair yoga, very simple and effective practices. So today in the chair yoga session we have Uttita Pada Hasta Padangusta Asana Sreni or somewhat raised hand to big toe poster series. So in this series we have nearly 8 posters. So all are very simple and very effective, and this will give you good leg stretching and also good exercise at the hip level, and also good for the people who are having this lower abdominal issues, and especially for the people, the women population who are having these menstrual cycle disorders, for them also this is very simple and effective postures. And especially it will bring some of the positive changes at the hip level, and it will give more activeness if you will do these exercises in morning and in the evening. So this is very simple, without any complication we are doing. Like keep your left hand on the chair's backrest. Keep your left hand on the chair's backrest. Keep your position straight and check your posture and check your legs, check your arm. Then here, keep your right leg back, left leg forward. Keep your right leg back, left leg forward. In between your two legs, create a small space. So back leg is your right leg. Then open your right leg forward, catch your right leg with the same side hand. So you can stretch your leg more if you want, if you can. Or if you have your previous experience to keep your leg lift more, you can just kick it up and automatically it will lift up. And stay now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then slowly come straight, then fold your leg and rest your leg. Then few seconds to check your two legs convenience. Because of these simple exercises, generally people will get a cramp or catch around the hip level. Then same thing here, keep your right leg back and open your right arm up, and back leg is your right leg. Lift your toe from the floor level. So according to your convenient point, so just make a stretch in the air and stay now. So this is what we call Ardha Chandrasana or half crescent posture. Few seconds to stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and relaxation. And slowly land your leg on the floor and slowly keep your arm down, and relaxation, long and deep slow inhalations and exhalations. So because of these two exercises, if you will think that your neck already got strength, just move your head as a half cycle. 1, 2, 3, and 4, relaxations, one long inhalations and exhalation. So in this same exercise, raise your hand to victor posture, cross section. This is what we call Uttita Hasta Padangusthasana, Parshva Padangusthasana. So here, keep your left leg forward, right leg back. Keep your left leg forward, right leg back. Then open your left leg to the right side, catch your ankle neck or ankle blade, or you can catch your toe also. But this is somewhat cross stretching, and stay here. So here this will improve the total structure of the leg, especially nerves region and then tendons and ligaments region. So especially that ankle leg will go to stretch more, and also it's a thigh, side part of the thigh also stretch more. And stay here. 1, 2, 3, and 4, relaxations enough, then slowly come back to normal. Take a long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. The same left leg, put it back. Then same right arm, open back. Then try to fold your left leg behind the body. So here also you can catch your ankle blade or ankle neck or toes. And now according to your convenience, according to your previous experience and interest, then try to kick your leg back and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, relaxation, then slowly come straight. Then take a long, deep inhalation and exhalation. Few seconds break for your breath. And just fold your legs and down, relaxations. Long, slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. Then simply about turn. As automatically chair will fall on your right side, and put your right hand on the chair, and few seconds keep a gap to do the next exercises, alternate side. We are doing the same practices, Uttita Hasta Padangusta Sreni, or raised hand to big toe posture series. Alright, and now keep your both the legs straight. Once take a long deep inhalation and exhalation, then open your left hand forward and open your left leg back from the position of the left leg. Open your left leg also forward. Then same thing here, catch your toe or catch your ankle neck or catch your ankle blade. Or you, still you can catch your pant clothes also. So here, according to your convenience, you can stretch. Or still if you have more flexibility and more confidence, you can still open the leg forward and turn the toe inside. Still if you want, open the leg up. Just according to your below legs condition, according to your body condition, lift your leg up and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then slowly come straight and fold your leg. Then after that, keep your leg down. Then once check your condition, check your legs, check your hips and thighs. This kind of leg exercises will definitely improve the leg stretching as well as pelvic stretching, and also good for the people who are suffering from this obesity issues. And the same thing here, we are doing back stretching, Ardha Chandrasana or half crescent posture. So here same leg is your left leg is your back leg. Then lift your left arm up and check your breath and check your convenience, and keep your right hand properly on the chair to take good support from the chair. Now this time slightly lift your back leg from the floor, then keep a back bend here and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then slowly get back to normal. Then after that, slowly keep your hand down and leg straight. And few seconds, relax your two legs by folding your legs and down. In the meantime, check your breath and long, deep and slow inhalation and exhalation. In the same series, in the same Sreni, Uttita Hasta Padangusta Sreni, we are doing cross leg stretching. So this time, keep open your right leg slightly back, open your left hand to the left side. So this what we call as Parshva Uttita Hasta Padangusta Asana. So here, open your right leg to the left side. So in some traditions, it's also called as Natarajasana variation, but we have many names for the same posture. But like choosing in a good way to the concerned posture is important rather than looking for the names. So open your right leg to the left side while twisting your ankle, while stretching your leg to the cross level. And stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 relaxations enough. Then slowly keep your leg fold. Then after that, release your leg and relax from the practice. Again, few seconds, relax. Long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. Then after your quick recovering time, keep your right leg slightly back. Open your left hand to the left side, but back stretch. Then try to see your back leg angle and your backside hand must come in your same line. After that, fold your right leg, catch your the toe junction or big toe or ankle neck or ankle blade with your left hand. Alright, use this technique for better leg pulling on the backside and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then slowly strides come back, resting and relaxing. Then again slowly move your legs forwards and backwards. Relax your two legs. Take again long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. So using these four postures, using this total Sreni, we can do some exercise also, especially like for the people who don't have much time to do the total warm-up or total like pre-practices for the yoga. So they can choose this simple exercise to warm up your body. So keep your right leg back and right arm up, just a movement. One, then slowly back stretch and forward stretch and back stretch, forward stretch, back stretch, forward stretch, and last count back and forward. Then okay, relaxations enough. Same thing here, cross hand, cross leg, the same exercise mode. So we are not doing postures now, exercise now, just movement. One, then slowly come back, touch and get back, and touch inside and get back, touch inside and get back, last count inside and slowly get back to normal relaxations. And opposite side, same thing, turn your body and put your right arm on the chair's backrest. Then same thing here, lift your left hand up, left leg back, then start movement. One, then slowly get back, stretch and forward and get back, stretch. Three, and get back, stretch. Four, get back, stretch. Last counts, five, and then stretch, relaxations. You know, take again long, deep slow inhalation and exhalation. And same thing here, left hand and right leg, left hand, right leg, just cross movement, and 2 and 3, last counts, 4 up and 5 up, and relaxation, enough, then strides. Again, just check your convenience and take long, slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. Alright, so by using the simple props which are available in everyone's home, like stick or like a chair, we can do lots of exercises in a proper way, also like in a easiest manner also. So like our next posture is itself called Padahastasana, standing forward bending posture or head to foot posture. For the people who are having repeated lower back pains or neck, for them maybe it has a restriction, unless remaining people, everyone can do this exercise. While using chair also, we can do this simple exercise, especially this posture exactly not comes under the actually the angle of the posture, but somehow 80% to 70% it will do the same stretch. But take care while doing. So stand in front of the chair, see your floor part of the chair must be facing you. Still, if you have a pillow or a small brick in your home, you can add that also, or you can do without bricks also, but still I will show these two variations. Alright, and now this time come closer to the chair, hold your chair with your two arms, especially keep your hands on the chair handles. Alright, now slightly wide the legs, very small gap in between the legs. Alright, then after that, using your hands and using the chair plastic handles, then completely bend the body without bending the knees. Without bending the knees, bend the body, still bend the body, try to put your head on the extra height pillow or on the brick. And few seconds to stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and relaxation. Lift your chin up, then very slowly come back. So here most of your body weight will be on the chair or will be on the leg, so that it will not create any special harm on your back. But take care while doing this kind of exercises. So same exercise here, slightly keep your legs back. Then keep your both the hands first on the chair's plastic handles. Further, leave your hands down to the chair's two legs. Then here, keep your head on the same chair, floor part of the chair. And stay here, leave your hands and few seconds to stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and relaxation, and slowly lift your arms and keep your hands on the chair, lift your head up, and very slowly get back to normal and relaxation. Enough, take a long pause. So benefit will be same, but you will not get more strain because of this standing forward bends. So here, if you want more gravity towards the bending forward, just keep your that special height or brick or pillow out and try to set your bending on the chair on. And this time also slightly wide the legs back and try to keep your hands on the chair's backrest or on the hands or on the chair's legs, hold it properly. Then very slowly bend the body forward and try to put your chin or forehead on the chair. So here throughout the practice you can hang the hands down. So while in this posture, if you can touch the floor, that's also fine. But few seconds to stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So without hurting your back, slightly come forward if you can. So that you will feel that kind of exert stretch on the hamstring muscle and exert contraction at your abdomen level. So this is also very simple and good posture in management of many abdominal disorders, but it depends on the practitioners and practices. And few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then slowly leave your hands. Then keep your hands on the chair. Then after that, slowly lift your chin and head. Then very slowly get back to normal. Then soon after that, once interlock your fingers back, keep your chest wide, expand your ribcage, close your eyes, and few seconds rest your breath. So during this kind of exercises, when anyone feels like a giddiness or a dizziness or any special throwing sensations, please try to care about the blood pressure issues. Alright, so as anyhow we did a forward bend, so we need to do back bending also. So you can choose any simple form of back bending, standing or sitting, standing or sitting. So here I'm doing first standing back bend called Ardha Chandrasana or Ardha Chakrasana arm lock variation, just head lock. So just take a long deep inhalation and exhalation. Siro Hasta Bandha Chakrasana. So hold your head properly, completely lift your chin up. On the base of the palms, few seconds stay now. So from the spinal cord level to head level, so feel that stretch without straining more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then so slowly come back, relaxations. Alright, very slowly wide your hands and rest and relaxations. Keep your body straight. So we may require another back bend that will be performed on the chair. So properly sit on the chairs and sit on the chair's forward edge and slightly come forward and take care of the balance, take care of your legs positions, keep your toes straight, keep your feet flat on the floor. Then after that, open your two hands towards the chair's backrest on the top or at the middle. On the top or at the middle. Hold your chair properly. So this time, allow your trunk for stretching forward while pulling the body back. Turn the shoulders back and observe the squeezing in between the shoulder blades. And also try to expand more your chest region and your ribcage region and lift your chin up and stay here for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, then very slowly come straight, resting and relaxation, and slowly leave your hands and take a long, slow, deep inhalations and exhalations. And our next series will be Veerabhadra Asana or Warrior Posture, the four postures. So we can do those exercises while using the chair also, because if you are doing the warrior posture on this kind of surfaces, so like 80% of your body weight will be on the chair and the posture will be same and almost benefits will be same. But please remember, when you are totally okay or when you if you can do this kind of exercises on plain mat, so give first importance to do this exercise without any prop helps. But we can do those exercises with the props also. So okay, keep your positions right and turn your body to the left side. Completely turn the body to the left side. Adjust your thighs, adjust your buttocks and adjust your back leg. So back leg is your right leg. So this time you can lift your back leg here or just keep your foot flat. Then try to check your forward leg convenience. Then take a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. This time open your two hands from side stretch or from forward. Just lift your both the arms up and put your both the shoulders almost behind the ears. So here do not interlock your fingers, but keep your both the palms together and check your breath and check your back leg condition and few seconds stay now. Throughout the practices, do not crunch your back. Completely keep pull up and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, then very slowly keep your hands down and release the posture and relaxations. So now take a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. Then slowly drag your back leg into inside. Then slowly turn your body straight and long, slow inhalations and exhalations. And opposite side, the same exercise, turn the body completely to the right side and adjust your body. Take support of the chair properly and back leg is your left leg. So here also you can lift your heel if you have any issues, or you can flat your ankle also, but take care while doing this exercise. And come forward from the forward edge of the chair. Forward leg is your right leg, and like fold your leg properly and keep your foot flat. Then here also observe carefully, lift your two arms up from forward, lift your arms up and stay for a while. Throughout the practice, keep turn the body to the exact right angle and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then very slowly come straight. Now open your two hands, then slowly forward, then bring them back Then after that, hold your chain and slowly drag your back leg inside and relaxation. So throughout this Virabhadrasana Sreni or this warrior posture, it will improve the leg like stretching conditions. Also, it will improve the knee strength and also good for the calf muscle. But please remember, when you have knee issues, better to choose a kind of good probe while doing this kind of exercises. So long, deep inhalation and exhalation. And coming to warrior posture 2, the same Virabhadrasana, other variation, only arm variation, leg structure will be same. Then towards your left side, turn the body and keep open your back leg. Back leg is your right leg. Make it flat or lift your heel. Make it flat or lift your heel. Alright, this time open your two hands forward, lift your arms up, then finally open your arms to the side stretch and make your arms parallel to the floor and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then turn the palms completely stiff and stay now. 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, relaxation, and slowly keep your hands forward, then very slowly keep your hands down, rest and relaxation, you know. Again, slowly drag your back leg forward, then after that, rest your spine and rest your breath, and long, slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. And here, similar pose, opposite side. Actually, this is very simple and effective postures in management of many thigh disorders or alignment disorders, especially for the people who are not able to walk properly because of posture problem. For them, this is very simple and effective postures. And opposite side, same thing, change your body style. Keep open your left leg properly, flat your feet out, lift the heel. Forward leg is your right leg, make it flat. In this time also, turn the body exactly in the direction of the folded leg knee. Then after that, open your two hands up. Then very slowly, wide your both hands to the side stretch. Then here, turn your palms and stay here in this posture. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then slowly lift your arms up, then very slowly keep your hands down in front of the body, then very slowly release and relaxation, enough. Again, slowly turn your body straight after dragging your back leg inside, then few seconds rest your spine, rest your legs. And coming to next exercise called Warrior Posture 3. So in many references, Warrior Posture 3 will be like another name also there for the same posture called Ekapadasana or T-shaped posture. That's also very simple and effective posture. So here, first of all, stand. Then keep your chair's backrest on the right side or on the left side. On the right side or on the left side. So put your right leg forward. So your right hand must come down on the chair's backrest. Alright, now this time back leg is your left leg and alternate hand is your left arm. Then completely give a stretch and stay in this posture while keeping your right hand. Take balance on the chair and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and then slowly come back to normal relaxation. Then long, deep and slow inhalation and exhalation. Then immediately after that, rest your spine and rest your knees. And same exercise, opposite side. Right, keep your position straight and come to preparation or pre-position samasthiti. Then after that, put your left hand on the chair to take good support from the chair. Then slightly open your right leg back. Then open your right hand vertical. Then see your back leg condition and above hand condition. It should come like a above part of the T. Then slowly stretch and stay now. Alright, use your left hand to take support from the chain. Throughout the practice, you can put your left hand on the chain also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and relaxation. Then very slowly come straight, resting. And then slowly keep your arms down. So during the same exercises, you can put your chair under the back leg also. But that's a different variation. I will show in the next week. Okay. And coming to last exercise, Yesterday also we did that exercise with the stick support called reverse warrior posture or Viparita Virabhadrasana or Urdhva Virabhadrasana. Alright, this is also very simple and effective posture. So slightly come forward from the chair. Then after that, turn your body to the left side, open your right leg properly, flat your feet. Then open leg side's hand should come on the thigh. Further, drag your hand till your knee or till your ankle or according to your convenience, alternate arm up. Throughout the practice, keep turn your body, bend your body more and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and relaxation. Then slowly come back while adding your below hand on the thigh. Then slowly keep your body straight and rest your body and relaxation. See now, slowly keep your hands and legs together and take a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. And more deep, long inhalation and exhalation. And same thing opposite side. First turn your body to the right side while adjusting your left leg properly back stretch. Flat your ankle or you can lift your back leg heel. So don't be very bothered about the body weight because your body weight will be on the chair. So try to stretch your open leg side's hand from the thigh level to knee or from knee level to ankle. So here throughout the practice, you can catch your chair handle with alternate arm till you reach your below part of the legs. Then alternate arm up, then completely give a bend and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then slowly come straight, release and very slowly come back to normal relaxation. Then after that, slowly keep your both the legs together and body straight. Once relax your legs by keeping them above and below movements. And take a long, slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. Alright, so coming to the pranayama session, it is also advised to give a small gap soon after your physical practices, like especially for the pranayama practices, according to your traditional belief, you can choose a sip of water also for drinking, especially for the mantra sadhana, it is also advised. Alright, coming to practices, here we have mantra sadhana and sloka practices. Okay, take a long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. You can choose a chair or a comfortable bed or any comfortable surface to sit properly while doing this kind of pranayama exercises. Om Kesavaya Swaha. Om Madhavaya Swaha. Om Narayanaya Swaha. Om Adya Samadhi Tatpala Sidyadham Asana Purvakan Pranayama Diyam Karishye. Om Sand Sand Sandhi. Then hands down and check your breath once. Take a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. So while doing the pranayama practices with the single hand interferences, so you can put your any kind of useful mudra or finger lock with the other hand to bring more awareness and also devotion into the practices. So today also we are doing chin mudra while doing our pranayama activity. So as we know that this is a gesture of consciousness, spiritual consciousness, and also it is facing the palms upwards. You can put it on the chair or on the knee. And also it is good in the mantra practices or pranayama practices or even in your meditation practices also. It is very simple and effective mudra. And it brings awareness in psycho-neural passages which will make our spiritual practices very powerful. It is a strong belief that many people have been following this kind of mudra and they are getting benefits also with these mudras. and also it helps to lift the dull energy and rectifies the overall mood. So whenever you have any kind of physical mental disturbances or fear or any other imbalances or unevenness in the mind, so with it, with the total devotion, try to do the simple practices. So this is what we call the Chin Mudra. Right, coming to Pranayam Sadhana. So in this Pranayam Sadhana also, we have today's exercises, two exercises. One is Surya Bhadana Pranayam. The second one is Bhastrika Pranayam. Surya Bhadana Pranayam, we know that it is a kind of right inhalation, left exhalation. It is saying that Kapala Sodhanam Vata Doshagnam Krimi Doshahrut Punaha Punaha Redam Karyam Surya Bhadana Uttamam. If the people wants to enjoy the extreme benefits of this Surya Vedana, they have to continue these practices for a long time. The extreme benefit is called, it will rectify the all wind level issues inside the skull, and also it will rectify the abdominal worms, the condition of the pain and everything from the abdominal level. And Vata Doshagna means inside the body also, it will rectify the wind level errors. It's what we call Vata Dosha. And coming to Bhastrika exercise, it is saying that Vata Pitta Slashma Haram Sari Ragni Vivardhanam Kundali Bodhakam Kshipram Pavanam Sukadam Hitam Brahma Nadi Mukhe Samasta Kapadhyarkala Nasanam. So basically, it will destroy the excess of phlegm, excess of wind and excess of biles inside the body. So it may be because of our activities, our food or our lifestyle. So whatever it will be, but Bhastrika can be useful to eradicate all these kind of excess doshas, and also it will raise the immunity, it will raise the metabolic activities. Also it is good for the people who have been doing this kind of spiritual practices, mantra sadhan or meditation or any spiritual efforts. Basically it will alert the body, it will give the good health to the lungs. And coming to the practices, so position straight and open your right hand, last two fingers and the right hand thumb to close and open the right nostril and left nostril and put it in front of the face. Obviously your right nostril will receive right thumb and your left nostril will receive last two fingers of the right hand. So close your left nostril and breathe in with the right. Then after that, very slowly breathe out with the left. Again slowly, completely right nostril inhalation. Again slowly, completely left nostril breathe out. And right nostril inhalation. And slowly, completely left nostril breathe out. And last inhalation with the right nostril. And completely slowly breathe out with the left. Slowly keep your hand down. So when you have more time in your home or at your self yoga practices, you can choose more time also to do this pranayam or any other postures to extend the time limit. And now coming to the next exercise called Bhastrika Pranayam. Bhastrika is a sharp inhalation, slow exhalation, complete opposite side process of Kapalabhati. So keep your position straight. You can hold your knee or you can hold your chair to keep your above back straight. And you can put your chin mudra for more awareness. You can press your index finger tip towards the thumb. And starting, we are not doing any advanced exercises in the pranayama. We are doing very light exercises. Alright, starting our first 10 strokes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1 quick inhalation and exhalation. And coming to second spell, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, one quick inhalation and exhalation. And third, last spell, the same Bhastrika. But please remember, when you have any blood pressure issues or ear problems or any other complications, avoid doing or do it very slow. Alright, third spell starting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. Then soon after that, you can just continue your exercises while doing your chin mudra by keeping your mind at your eyebrow center or at your breath to do your meditation. The same chin mudra also very helpful while you are doing meditations and the mantra chantings. And once you will be able to finish your the total yoga practices, still please try to give some more time to take a rest in the form of yoga nidra or power nap. And once you will totally finish your yoga practices, including this power nap and including resting techniques, and please take 15 minutes time to half an hour time to take bath, and further 10 minutes time to take breakfast. But these timings totally depend on the people to people and their practice sessions and their intensity and quality of the practices. And in the afternoons, once you will be free from your activities, especially before your lunch hour, lunch time, again please take some more time to give relaxation to the body and mind in the form of power nap or in the form of yoga nidra abhyas. It will improve the quality of the mind and thought process, and also it will definitely give positive changes in decision makings, and altogether it will improve the productivity from you. And in the evenings, once you will be totally free from your all activities and affairs before your dinner time, and choose at least half an hour time to do self yoga exercises, including back bending exercises and inversion postures and leg stretchings, because evening body is very flexible rather than the morning body, so that you can utilize that kind of benefit from the body. And along with your yoga practices, especially in the evening, do at least one or two breathing exercises also. It will improve your sleep quality. And tomorrow, when we are meeting here at the same place with the same content, we will see still more good exercises in yoga. Until then, take care of yourself, stay away from the bad habits, and do yoga also. Thanking you all.